It's Friday, January 10th. I'm Kyle Gary, and this is your weekly look at stories from the Hale Center for Journalism at KCPT. We call it The Breakdown. Each year, thousands of people are injured by poisonous chemicals in their homes. While these chemicals are safe when used properly, the injury occurs when it's time to get rid of them. Science reporter John McGrath traveled to household hazardous waste sites in both Kansas and Missouri and gives a behind-the-scenes look at disposal.
With over 1 million pounds taken in annually, their job is to keep these dangerous materials from being dumped in landfills, waterways, and other areas that it shouldn't belong.
The Toy Miniature Museum in Midtown Kansas City is closed for a lengthy renovation. As a part of our Curator's Choice series, reporter Lindsay Foate spoke with museum educator Laura Taylor about a storied dollhouse in their collection. The museum will reopen in 2015 as the National Museum of Toys and Miniatures.
She was born in 1889 here in Kansas City. Her parents were successive presidents of the Emery Bird Thayer Department Store.
The number of people enrolled in WIC, a federal nutrition program in Kansas, is down. But the number of people living below the poverty level is up. Health reporter Mike Sherry investigates this puzzling trend in an article at kcpt.org/health. Phone cases. Pretty much everyone has one. They protect your phone, they look stylish, but can they do more than that? The people at Red Dirt think so. As part of our startup Snapshot series, I sat down with the co-founders who say their cases help fight the water crisis in Africa.
There is a piece of philanthropy built into each and every transaction.
How hard is it to make a cell phone case? Well, it turns out it's really hard. It's harder than we ever imagined.
And that's all for The Breakdown this week. You can find all these stories and more online at kcpt.org. Also, follow us on Twitter at @KCPTNews. I'm Kyle Gary, and I'll see you next week.